everyone, welcome to yet another episode of Lockdown Diaries with me, Hesha Chima. In today's episode, I've got with me none other than one of the top 15 finalists of VLCC Femina Miss India 2020, and that's the lovely, gorgeous Angela Kumar. Hi Angela, welcome to the show.
Hello ma'am, how are you?
I'm doing well, how have you been? It's been so long.
Yes, exactly, I'm doing great.
So, you know, Angela, I want to actually start off by complimenting you on the super strong A game that you have on your Instagram. I mean, oh my God, I love your dance videos. I'm absolutely inspired and motivated by your fitness videos. And we all know, I think, what a big fitness freak that you are. So coming to the question, how do you manage to be so motivated and inspired at such a young age?
First of all, thank you so much. I'm really glad that my mission of inspiring and motivating people is really working out. So it has been almost a year of being in a lockdown, and yet every day is so exciting for me because I have a schedule going on. So every day, early morning, I wake up and there's this one thing that I really believe in. Even the small things that I do each day, it makes me a better person. So I make it a point every day to make the most out of it. So the vision, the picture of me being a better, a fitter person, that image always stays in my mind. So the things that I need to do to achieve it, that is what motivates me to actually achieve it and keep on.
Wow, I think I'm going to definitely take a few pointers here and there from what you've just said, because I'll tell you what, we are in a lockdown situation and whatever is happening around us right now is kind of inevitable, right? But I think what matters and what helps us keep going is the fact that we have something to look forward to in the day. So I think, Angela, the fact that you have been following, I'm presuming, a routine or probably something that you do productively, why don't you share your productive morning routine with us, along with probably an evening or a night routine that you may have or follow?
All right, so the glimpse of a day with Angela is that in the morning, every alternate day, I wake up really early, 5:30. I go for cycling for 1.5 hours. Then I come back, and it's my favorite time of the day, which is mom's breakfast. So I really take out my time, an hour and a half, just eat it and finish those lovely parathas. And then after that, I do the household chores. So that's another cardio for me. And after that, I take a break. So I watch Netflix, do some relaxing, take a bath. In the afternoon, I take a nap. And around that, I really like to spend time with my family. So we all sit down to watch a movie or just have a chat. Then I have my pre-workout snack, which I really, really love. And after that, I do my workout for 1.5 hours or so. And sometimes I get lazy, so rest days. Then I make my dinner with some pop jazz music. So that really helps me to, you know, I really feel like I'm in a movie. So it really makes me very happy. So cooking my own dinner is another therapy for me. I love cooking. So I try out new recipes. Then I go for a walk with my German shepherds. And that is another therapy, is family time. Then I go for sleep. So it's a really happening day for me.
Yeah, I mean, clearly you have so many things to do. Like, ask me and I'd be like, hey, Angela, I'm probably lying down on my bed and Netflix and chilling. What is it that, what was the first moment in your life that you realized that this is it, Angela? No matter what happens in my life, fitness, dance is something for my body that I'm going to do no matter what. When was that moment?
That moment when I realized that I could dance, which is 5 years ago. And almost 6 years now, that was the moment when I really discovered that there are a few things that I can do, which I think no one around me really knows that I can. So that is something hidden about. So once I got to know that I can do stuff that people really don't have the motivation to, that motivated me more. So that is how I started practicing all these things. And competition with myself is something that gets me going. So if you tell me that someone else has set this record, so I make sure that I break that record, and then I set a new record even after that, and then I break that record. So it really helps me to keep on breaking records.
Oh yeah, like I think you have been breaking a lot of records. But tell me, Angela, like, what is that one sort of tip or message that you may have probably for all the budding, you know, pageant inspired, like, you know, people who want to probably participate in a pageant? What is it that you'd like to tell them, like, from your experience and from your journey?
From my experience, it's really important for a person to stay true to themselves, because I've seen in order to win a pageant, people think that they have to speak and think in a certain way, which is not correct. It's not true. So you really need to work on yourself and stay true and honest to yourself and genuine, real and kind to other people. So that is very important in pageants.
That's really sweet to say, and I think it's very truthful also, because it does happen that sometimes we do get carried away by the superficial stuff, but I think staying true to yourself is the utmost important. Tell me, Angela, how else have you been keeping yourself occupied during the lockdown? Is there any favorite show that you've been binge watching?
Yes, actually, there is a show called Brooklyn Nine-Nine. So I really wanted to like that show, but I never really got the hang of it. But once I started watching it, it was like my favorite. So Brooklyn Nine-Nine is something that I watch, and along with my mom and dad, I watch Blacklist. So this is a mix of humor and mystery and everything together. So I really binge watch on these shows.
And is there any book that you're reading right now?
I just finished a book called Ikigai, and it's really good.
I've read the book too. How was your experience with the book?
It was really good. It was really refreshing to read the lines that they've written and the deep meanings. I'm a person who really likes to get the facts behind and the reasons that actually make up the words. So I really love the book, and it has so many things. Like, it's so magical that you can get to know about this world just by reading a few paragraphs. So that is how I felt by reading the book.
Yeah, I absolutely love reading books in general. I think as of now, that's one of my go-to things to do in the lockdown, which is reading a lot of books, of course, being lazy and watching shows, but yeah. Angela, I really want to know what's like your go-to dance move if you ever hit a party or a pub. Like, just show me a move.
I really like popping. So I really like to just jerk off my body, and then, you know, because it gives that groove. So even if I'm grooving, if I do tuck tuck, so it shows that I'm a dancer, and yeah, I'm a party girl as well, even though I like dressing more, so, but still.
You mentioned, Angela, that you really enjoy cooking, and I think that's something that you've been doing during the lockdown as well. What all have you cooked, Chef Angela? Please let us know.
I'm a big fan of healthy stuff, so anything that's unhealthy, cookies, cake, I try to make it healthy. So I try to make oatmeal cakes, which is really healthy, as well as it suppresses your appetite. So oatmeal cookies, cakes, mixing multigrain dough with this, and, you know, just experimenting these dishes.
So if I had to tell you to choose between cooking and like dancing, what would you pick?
Dancing.
Yeah. And if I tell you between dancing and reading a book, then what would you pick?
You're giving me some hard choices, huh? I need to think of it. I think it depends on my mood, of course, because I really love both the things, but I still will choose dancing.
Oh, so you're like dancer, born dancer by heart, I'm gonna live like one. Oh, that's crazy. Tell me, Angela, tell me something, you know, especially during your pageant days, one of the most important things is to make sure that you are fit, not just like physically, but also mentally, because you are in a very competitive environment at the end of the day. So as much as we know that you're into like, you know, physical fitness, what is it that you do to keep your mental sanity in check?
For me, it's really important to identify when I'm going into the negative path. So whenever I have a negative thought, I let myself think it. I really treat it as a guess, and then I let it go. So I don't ignore my negative thoughts, but I really absorb them in, and then I try to look at the positives. So it's really important to talk to yourself positively. So in cases when I'm feeling negative about myself or the situation, I just tell myself things which might not be true, but which are positive. So just the positive affirmations, they really make a lot of difference.
Yeah, I think I'm into affirmations as well. So I do relate to that. Maybe not every day, but I do tend to, like, you know, keep myself into that zone. Tell me something, Angela. Is journaling something that you're into as well? Have you tried journaling?
Yes, I have.
Yeah, and did you, like, stick to it? Because I couldn't. So I really want to, like, talk to people who probably did end up, like, you know, sticking to journaling. So how was your experience with that?
So I think that earlier I used to make it a point to journal every day, but that didn't work out for me because I used to sometimes be very tired and there was work to do. So I just thought of making it something like a friend. So whenever I feel like sharing something with myself or the diary, I just note it down, because it's really important to, you know, even if you have a few of days when you don't feel like writing, it's all right. But journaling, when you have bottled up emotions or when you want to motivate yourself, so that time you can do the journaling part.
You know, I know there's a little bit more scope, and you can tell me that probably that one face pack of yours that you make at home, which you use for yourself. So just spill it all out to me.
I really like to use sandalwood and uktan. So sandalwood and uktan, there's a mix of it, and you probably put lemon juice in it. You make an uktan out of it. So you have basin, you have lemon, you have malai, a little bit of milk, haldi, and that's it. And honey, yeah. So this is something that really gives you a glow. And sandalwood, add sandalwood if you have it. So this powder really naturally brings out the glow in your face. And me having an oily skin, that really helps me to, you know, get a refreshed skin. So that is one thing. And one more tip for oily skin is peel off mask. So they really help to clear out your skin, really, like, vacuum all the black out.
I'm going to try the peel off mask and the DIY mask for sure. And I'm so sure that everybody watching this video on our Beauty Pageants YouTube channel will definitely try this out as well, because you are glowing and it's all evident, and we see you all motivated and always excited to put up something new. And tell me something, I always want to ask, you know, people who are also content creators, right? So you are a content creator yourself, you are running your own Instagram page and you create content, put up content every single day. So it's two different things, right? Number one is when you yourself need to be motivated sort of to work out first. So that's one part of it. But you also need some kind of motivation when you have to put yourself out there publicly and create content, right? What's your strategy like? Like, how do you put yourself as a content creator out there? And what are the few tips that you may want to give to, you know, budding bloggers or content creators or just pageant fans and aspirants?
I really believe that a content creator, an artist, is an artist because of their unique. So the first point would be to really discover your space. So the areas that you are comfortable in shooting, stuff that you really have fun shooting. So that is something that, even if it may not have views, many views or many likes, but in the starting, it will give you a boost to actually create better content. So I think it's really important to first try all your best to see where you are comfortable, and then start shooting step by step. After that, you can. What really works out well for me is, even while doing workout randomly or just you know, dancing, I just switch on my camera. So not with the intention to shoot a video, but me just having fun. And I've posted so many videos and they've turned out to be so great. So it's really important for the content creators to just not plan everything. So even while they're having their own gala time, just switch on the camera and do whatever you want to in front of it. So you really get a lot of fun content out of it.
So basically, you mean to say that be really real and create content that you thoroughly enjoy creating for yourself, not just for the people.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that really makes a lot of sense. Angela, this was such a quick, short, fun chat with you. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I'm so sure the people watching this episode also would enjoy it. There's a lot of motivation to take back from. There's a lot of tips to take back from. And of course, you've shared, you know, how you keep yourself, you know, productive. And I think that's going to definitely motivate all of us to make sure that our days are also a lot more productive. So thank you so much, Angela, for joining us today. Why don't you tell our our audiences what is it that they need to do if they have liked this video?
To watch more such amazing content, I really want you guys to like, share, and don't forget to subscribe Beauty Pageant page, and also comment down below what you guys would love to see next. Stay safe and take care.